Hey there, my friend, Abbi from Abbi Kirsten Collections here, and in this short bite-sized design space lesson, I want to talk about the templates tab that is over here in the design panel. All right, so I get questions quite often in my community about how do I size things correctly for like t-shirts? How do I size things relative to if I'm working with an image and text? And how to just work with the templates feature in general to try and help yourself scale things to a relative size for your particular blank that you're applying your design to. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm gonna go ahead and get a fresh canvas here. I just wanted to show you kind of where we are going. All right, so first things first, we want to have a design to put onto a template. You may already have one ready to go, and that's fine, but I'm gonna take this from the perspective of maybe we're pulling an image in from Cricut Access, or maybe we've uploaded an image. Maybe we're typing some text out and we wanna combine some text and an image together, okay? So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm just gonna use a Cricut Access image here as an example, but you can apply the concept across, you know, any other type of image you might be using. So I'm gonna click on images. I'm just gonna type in the keyword dog, and I'm going to find me a dog image. I'm gonna take this one here as an example, and I'm gonna click add to canvas. All right, so we're gonna have that there. Don't worry about the size yet. I'm gonna type some text out on my screen here. I'm gonna type out by grabbing the text tool, double click inside of it if you need to get back to that cursor setting. And I'm gonna start by just typing out, I just want to drink coffee. And then I'm gonna start another text box. And pet my dog is gonna be the second. Okay, then I wanna change this font. It's not the font I want. So with one of these texts selected, go up to the font option. You can use a Cricut font, you can use a system font. I'm gonna use a system font that I've installed. It's called Paw Wow, super cute. I'm gonna take this one here, okay? And then I'm also gonna change this one as well so they match. Okay, so I have these two items here. I feel like the text is probably pretty good in size to this image here. A lot of this is your preference, but I'm gonna select this line and then hold my shift key and select the bottom line, and then I'm just gonna scale it down just a touch, okay? That way they're both matching in size there. All right, so I'm gonna take this top one here. I wanna kind of create a curve around this design, so that's just how I want this to look. I'm gonna click on the curve option here with my font selected, and I'm just gonna pull it to the right until it curves nicely like that. So it's landing on 82 for me. You could leave it with like this line straight, but I'm gonna try this one at a curve also. So going back to curve, I'm gonna curve this the opposite direction, right, like that. And let's pull this down a bit. You can kind of see that circle forming there. Okay, I feel like this doggy could be bigger now, so I'm gonna scale him up just a little bit. All right, I actually feel like I went a little too extreme on the curve. I'm gonna back it up just a tiny bit. Take it back just a little bit there. Okay, that's better. That's more what I want. All right, and I'm gonna enlarge this guy back up just a touch. Okay, so that's a quick design that I just made there. We could put this on anything. I'm gonna show you a t-shirt example in this case. Now, as far as me choosing the sizes here of this image and this text, this is relative to the final look of the design that I want. But I am gonna show you what you can do to make sure this looks right on the blank that you're putting it onto, okay? So let's click and drag over these pieces here. I have three separate pieces, so I'm gonna click and drag over them, and I'm just gonna group them together so they will move as one. Right click and hit group, and I'm just gonna set this aside. And let's scale it down just a touch. Let's visit that templates tab now. So under templates here, you're gonna see quite a few different options, and you'll be able to scroll through them all rather quickly to see everything we have, you know, pants and shirts, and we have towels and even things like, you know, bibs for babies and glasses and flip-flops and things like that. I'm gonna take a simple t-shirt. So let's go with a scoop neck t-shirt. That's quite common. So we'll click on that. And then our entire canvas is going to auto adjust for us. And you'll see up here that it says templates are for reference only and will not be saved in your project. So once you have saved this, closed it out, navigated away from this screen or gone to the cut screen, the template's gonna disappear with it, okay? You can always bring it back, but just know that they're not gonna be saving as a part of your project. All right, so this whole screen has adjusted here. We can see we are much more zoomed out because if we look at our ruler guides along the top and the side here, you can see that it's going to like over 56 inches here and 28 inches down here. So they've really zoomed the canvas out here to give us perspective on what a t-shirt would be like. Now take note up at the top here, the top of Design Space changed when we put a template on it. So we now have some options up here. There is a type. Right now it's set to a men's short sleeve shirt. So I'm gonna change that to woman short sleeve. And then you can select your size. Now, if you just want a very loose reference, you can select any of these general sizes here. So for me, maybe I would just do woman's and then medium, which is for me. But if you want to get more specific, and this is what I recommend if you want to be absolutely accurate as possible, see the option where it says custom here? If you click on that, it gives you the ability to set the width and the height here. Now, one thing that's a little bit challenging about this is it's doubling the width here because it's giving us a front and a back to work with. So the shirt we would be measuring, if we were measuring a shirt in front of us right now to type in custom dimensions, we wouldn't be measuring a 67 inch wide shirt in most cases because this is representing the front and the back of the shirt, okay? So take note of that. You wanna pay attention to the height more than anything. So I want you to take your particular shirt out. Let's say that's what we're working with here in these templates examples. Take your particular shirt out, select the type, and then select custom if you wanna get really specific. And if, let's say my shirt was 30 inches high from the top of the shoulder to the bottom hem of the shirt. So I'm just gonna type in 30 inches and then hit enter and it'll adjust for you. And you'll also see the other side adjust. So we see that the width also adjusted when we did that. And that's why it's important to focus on the height. So if I know that my shirt that I just measured with a measuring tape is 30 inches, that's giving me a little bit more custom control when I'm working with my particular template here. And if we select the design, you'll notice as soon as we go back to selecting the design, our original edit bar at the top reappears, okay? And at this point, you can just carry on as normal. So come to one of these corners. This is a little under 5.5 inches or right around 5.5 inches for this design. Clearly we can see in reference to this template, it's a little on the small side. Unless perhaps you want to put it over here on like a lapel sort of situation, that would be a cool way to visualize that. So maybe you want your shirt to look like that. But let's say we want to put it in the center front of our shirt. This is the front, this is the back. I would come to one of these corners and scale it up. Now, we've set this template dimension to the same height of our shirt that we would measure in person. So it should give us a fairly accurate representation of what we're seeing here when it comes to the scale. So at this point, you would just scale larger or smaller to decide visually with your eye what you want that to look like on your shirt. Now, we all know scoop neck, we see this the neck part here. So this is the chest right here going between the two sleeves. And then of course, this would be the stomach area. So keep in mind, you know, how far do I want this to go down? Sure, this could go bigger. We could crank it up quite a bit like that. Okay, so let's say we cranked it up to where it's almost filling the entire surface area of the shirt. And you could absolutely do that, But keep in mind that this design, when it's applied to our shirt, if you've set your templates or dimensions here according to what you're working with, it is going to come all the way down to around the stomach area. If you need to get a more specific visual with your particular shirt, I recommend once you've set a scale here using these templates in Design Space, take note of the size that you've got going on here. So this entire thing, and we'd have to cut it out in sections, but this entire thing is 16 by 17 inches. So grab a measuring tape and check like the center part of your shirt and measure, you know, 17 inches high by 16 and a half inches wide on the shirt, and just place that measuring tape on your shirt and get a visual for what that's going to look like. It can be really helpful to use these templates in here and then compare it when you're looking at your shirt in person before you make your final choice, okay? I personally wouldn't do something this large. I would bring it down to something that's more in the center of the chest area. So this is in the 8-inch area now, and then I would center it like that. Now, if you're working with the back of a t-shirt, for example, I'm just going to duplicate this real quick. Back of shirts definitely look better with larger designs. So in that case, you could scale this up. Again, you could, you know, check what that might look like measuring a second time on your shirt to give yourself sort of that visual. And then you could get an idea. But you can see like back of the shirts generally work better for bigger things. Front of the shirts, a little bit smaller, or keep it to the chest area or the lapel area for designs like that, okay? Now, if you wanted to, of course, you could ungroup this and you could play around with the text here. If you wanted to scale this larger, you could, but it's really all relative to what are you putting this on and what do you want it to look like in the end? Do you want the text to be larger? Do you want it to kind of all look like it's fitting more together? In a smaller space, that's ultimately your choice, okay? So just think about that from your perspective. Now, I wanna show you a couple of other things with the templates. If you look down here in the layers panel, you're going to see that it has the template name, and you'll see a little eyeball tool there. If you click it, it'll hide it automatically if you just wanna like, you know, hide it for whatever reason to get it off your canvas for a second, and then you can bring it back. And when you bring it back, it'll also bring back that type, that size, and height and width there. So you can change things out again if you need to. You can also change the color, which I think is really fun. Let's say you're working with a blue shirt or something like that. So maybe I have like a pale blue shirt I'm working with. Okay. And maybe I know that, here, let me get this one off my screen since I messed up with the curve that we had going there. Scale this back down. Let's say we know this is gonna be white on a blue shirt. We could change that to get a better visual, and we wanna zoom in here. Maybe the shirt I'm using is, a darker blue. So we could change it to a darker blue and then bring that eyeball tool back, and now we have our darker blue. Okay, so that gives us a nice visual of what the result could look like. And these settings are very similar no matter what template you use. So maybe I want to insert an oven mitt instead. Now, whenever you bring in another template, it's going to kick the existing template out. But we can see on our screen here, it doesn't even look like we can see the template. And it took me a minute to realize that sometimes you actually need to change the color to be able to visually see it. So I'm gonna change this to a blue so we can see it. There we go, there it is. All right, and then we still have options here, like we can select the standard size or we can select custom if we want to be able to type in dimensions. Note that if you select customs and stuff, it may revert back to a different color. So just take note of changing the color there to be able to get that visual guide to appear on your canvas. And let's say for whatever reason, we're using this same design for an oven mitt, and then we could use this as reference to place here and get an idea. We could hide our template in that layers panel, or maybe we don't have a blue oven mitt, we have a red one instead. That gives us more of a visual there. So that's the beauty of using templates to help yourself with guiding your sizes. The biggest takeaway from all of this is to always, always measure. Have a measuring tape on hand, measure your blanks, measure the area you want it to cover, and then pay attention to the size of the design, the final size of the design here in Cricut Design Space, so you can have a very clear idea of the reference to how big your design is in reference to how big or small your particular blank or t-shirt or whatever is, okay? Let me know if you have any questions. I'll be happy to help you.